Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to show you how to make this big flower. I made the flower with two different kind of yarn. It's the same pattern, but the yellow flower is made with sports weight cotton yarn and the bigger flower is made with aran weight cotton yarn. You can use any yarn that you like. It's a good idea to always use the smallest hook recommended on the label of the yarn. This flower is perfect for to sew on bags or for your macaroni or sew it on a hat, for example. Well, you could do a lot of things with the flower. If you want to make a small flower, I also have a small flower video. The link should be in a corner right now to the video. The yarn I'm going to use in the video, I'm going to make the yellow flower. This is the yarn that I use, sport weight cotton yarn. And you also need a hook. I'm going to use a 2.5 millimeter crochet hook. And of course I need some scissors. And I use the embroidery needle with a blunt point to sew everything together. And you need also a little bit of stuffing for the middle part of your flower. And some pins to put everything together before you start sewing. Yeah, and that's it. Now we can start. I'm going to start with a magic circle. We're going to make 5 petals. I will show you one and then you can make 5 more. I'm going to start with a magic circle by wrapping the yarn twice around my finger. I'm going to go into the magic circle with my crochet hook and grab the yarn. Now there's one loop around my crochet hook. Now I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it to the hook on my crochet hook. Now this is the magic circle. Now we're going to make 6 single crochets into this magic circle. Now to do that I'm going to go into the 2 loops, grab the yarn and pull it to the loop. I have 2 loops on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it to the loops on my crochet hook. Then I'm going to go into the magic circle again, grab the yarn, I have 2 loops on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn again and pull it to the loops on my crochet hook. Now I'm going to make my 3rd single crochet. 2 loops on my crochet hook, grab the yarn, pull it through. This was the first the 3rd single crochet. Now I'm going to make the 4th. And the 5th. If you think that this is going too fast, you can always slow down the video to watch it even slower. Now this is the 6th. Now I'm going to close my magic circle. I'm going to pull that little piece of yarn that's sticking out, just a little bit, not completely closed around yet. Just pull it a bit. You'll see that one of the loops is getting smaller. I'm going to pull that one to close the other one. And once it is closed, I'm going to pull the small piece of yarn again. And now I've closed the magic circle. Now, this was round 1. Now we're going to continue to round 2. In round 2, we're going to make an increase in every stitch of the round. This means we have to go do a single crochet twice in the same stitch. First I'm going to put a piece of yarn before I start with the next round, so I know where all the new rounds start. And now I'm going to do an increase in every stitch of the round. So in this stitch, I'm going in there. Oh, not this one. Both of the loops. And I'm going to grab the yarn, pull it through. 2 loops from a crochet hook, grab the yarn again and pull it to the loops. This is the first single crochet. Now I'm going to go into the same stitch and make the second single crochet. And this is also called an increase. Two single crochets in the same stitch. I'm going to do this 5 more times. So in the end I will have 12 stitches. So again, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. If you like to crochet, learn how to crochet, then don't forget to like my video and subscribe to keep updated for future videos. So now I did 3 times, now I'm going to have to do 3 more times, 2 single crochet in the same stitch. Now I'm going to do the go into the 5th stitch. And I made the increase. Now in the last stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Now I've made 12 stitches in this round. Now round 3 till 5. 3, 4, 5 going to be really easy. I'm just going to do 1 single crochet in every stitch of the round. Now this is the first and then the second. I'm going to do this for in all 12 stitches of the round, just 1 single crochet. And I'm going to do that for round 3, 4 and 5. I'm going to speed up the video a bit because this is quite the same for 3 rounds. Now this is the last stitch of round 5, and then I can start with round 6. First I'm going to move the marker yarn a bit, and then we're going to do 1 stitch in the first stitch, in 1 single crochet in the first stitch, and then a decrease. So this is the single crochet in the first stitch, and to make a decrease we're going to go into the front loop of the next 2 stitches. So I'm going to go into this front loop and then I'm going to go into the front loop of the second stitch. Now I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it to those 2 loops. Now then I should have 2 loops on my crochet hook. Okay, I'll do that again. So into the front loop, also in that front loop, and pull the thread to the front loops. Now I have 2 loops on my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it to those 2 loops. Now that's how you make a decrease. In the next stitch I'm going to do 1 single crochet. And then I'm going to do a decrease again. So in the front loops, next from the next 2 stitches, grab the yarn, pull it to the front loops. And then you have 2 loops on your crochet hook, grab the yarn and pull it to both loops. Now the next 1 single crochet, then I'm going to make a decrease. Now the next stitch 1 single crochet. And I'm going to crochet the next 2 stitches together. Now round 6 is finished and 1 petal is finished. I'm going to fasten off it by making a single crochet in the next stitch. To do that I'm going to go into the stitch, grab the yarn and pull it to the loop on my crochet hook immediately. And that's how you make a slip stitch. Now I'm going to flatten it to make it a petal, and I'm going to cut the yarn for my magic circle. I'm going to leave this part of yarn. I need it to sew on the petals on the middle flower middle. You have to make 4 more. And now I'm going to show you how to make the middle of the flower. I'm going to start with a magic circle. Wrap the yarn around your finger twice. Then go into the 2 loops with your crochet hook and grab the yarn. Pull it through both loops. Now I have 1 small loop on your crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it through the loop on my crochet hook. Now this is the magic circle. I'm going to make 5 single crochets into this magic circle. I'm going to do that by going into the magic circle, grab the yarn. I have 2 loops on my crochet hook now. And grab the yarn and pull it through both loops on my crochet hook. I have to do this 4 more times. Go into the magic circle, grab the yarn, 2 loops on your crochet hook, grab the yarn again, pull it through both loops. I have to make 3 more single crochets. One more. Now I've made 5 and I can close the magic circle. I'm going to do it by pulling this little piece of yarn. As you can see that 1 loop is becoming smaller. I'm going to pull that loop to make the other one. Close the other one completely. Then I can pull the small piece of yarn again and close the magic circle. Now we're going to do an increase in every stitch of the next round. First I'm going to put in some marker yarn. I'm just using some leftover yarn. I'm going to go into this first stitch and I'm going to make an increase to 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Now this is the increase. Now in the second stitch also 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And in the end we should have made 10 stitches. Because of the increase, we're going from 5 to 10 stitches. You can see I always use pieces of yarn for my marking. That's because I don't want to use plastic markers because I think there's already too much plastic in this world. So now we're going to start with round 3. First I'm going to make 1 single crochet in the first stitch. And in the second stitch I'm going to make an increase. So 2 single crochets in the same stitch. I'm going to repeat this 5 more times. Oh, I have to do this over. So now I'm going to make an increase. Now the next stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. Again, 1 single crochet in the next stitch. and 2 single crochets in the second stitch. One single crochet in the next stitch. 2 single crochets in the second stitch. One single crochet in the next stitch. And the increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch in the last stitch. Now I'm going to move my margin, so now where my round will start. And then I'm going to start with round 4. In round 4, 5 and 6, we're going to single crochet 1 time in each stitch of the round. So this is really 3 really easy rounds, just 1 single crochet in every stitch. And we will do that for round 4, 5 and 6. That's why I'm going to speed up the video, because it's well, quite the same for 3 rounds. Now these are the last 2 stitches of round 6, sorry, and then we're going to start with round 7. In round 7, we're going to do 1 single crochet in the first stitch and the single and crochet in the next 2 together. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet, then the second and the third stitch go into the front loops of the next 2 stitches. Then grab the yarn and pull it to both front loops. You have 2 loops on your crochet hook. Grab the yarn again and pull it through those loops. Now I've repeated that 4 more times. In the first stitch 1 single crochet and then another decrease. Crochet the next 2 together. And the next stitch 1 single crochet and crochet the next 2 together, go into the front loops. In the next stitch 1 single crochet and then another decrease. In the next stitch, 1 single crochet and crochet the next 2 together. And then we are done with round 7. In the next round, round 8, we're going to decrease 6 times. So make crochet the next 2 together. Repeat that. Oh, 4 more times. Sorry, it was, of course, it is 5 times and not 6. Now I'm done with this round. Now I'm going to fasten off. I'm just going to cut the yarn and pull it through. And then I can put some stuffing into this little ball that we made. I also don't need the mark yarn anymore. I'm just going to pull it out. And I'm going to put some stuffing in the middle. Because this is of course the too small to put my hands in, so I'm going to use a little tool to put the stuffing in. I always like to use a chopstick for this to do this. As you can see, I put in a lot of stuffing. Now we're going to I'm going to grab an embroidery needle with a blunt point, because I'm going to close the hole. To do this, I'm going to sew into the front loops of all the last stitches that we made in the last round. Down all 5 stitches. And then we can pull the yarn to close the hole, and you sew in the remaining yarn into the crane ball. If you want, you can leave this piece of yarn on your ball so you can sew your flower onto something if you like. I'm going to sew it in several times, because I don't want it to become loose. Now I'll show you how to sew the petals on this flower middle. All of the petals take up 3 stitches, and I'm going to sew them on round 5 of the flower middle. I will show you every step of this, because I know it can sewing these parts together can be quite difficult, and I know a lot of people like to see exactly how it's sewn on. I'm using pins to keep it in place while sewing it on the flower middle. So every petal takes up 3 stitches of round 5 of the flower middle. Now, soon on the first petal, I'm going to hide the yarn in the petal and cut it off. Now I'm going to sew on the second petal. Now I've sewn on two petals and now I'm going to sew on the third one. Now we have to sew on two more petals, then the flower is done. I'm going to sew the fourth petal on now. So if you can see that the because you continue to crochet, the wound isn't completely ending at the beginning of the first petal, so you have to put it in between both petals and then sew it on so they look like they fit exactly next to each other. I hope this makes sense. Well, I'm going to show you exactly how I sew it on. Now I just have to hide the remaining yarn and then my flower is done. I hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please like the video, and it would be nice if you could subscribe to my channel. Then you will also get informed of future videos, and I'm planning on making many more. Let me know in the comments what if you made your flower and where you're going to use it for. Please check my do-it-yourself fluffies YouTube channel for many more videos, including a lot of amigurumi videos. You can, for example, find these very cute amigurumi on my YouTube channel. They are all very fun small projects, great for beginners to learn how to crochet. I've had many people telling me that they learned how to make amigurumi with these videos. And these were all made with sport weight cotton yarn. And you can use any yarn that you would like to use for these creatures. Here I made one with bigger yarn and a bigger crochet hook. It's also 100% cotton yarn, but then Aran weight, and with a 4mm crochet hook. If you want to make a little bit more complicated projects, bigger projects, then you can find a lot of patterns in my Etsy and Revely shop. You can find the links in the description of this video. For example, this koala and this deer. I also have a video about how to connect the legs of this deer. This cute stegosaurus. I hope I say it correctly in English. And a little monster. Again, I have loads of patterns in my shop, so these are just a few of my designs. This is Billy the Pig with a little beach ball. My chef bear, which also has a spoon, but I couldn't find it. my donkey. It has a bit of hair. It's a bit flat because it lay in a box for a while. My Mr. Blue monster. This is also, some of the patterns are also found in several books. For example, amigurumi monster books. And all of them that I'm showing you are found in my my shops. This is Yogi the Dragon. Well, again, thank you very much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the video.